right, so the next exercise we're going to go over is the cable chop. It's a really functional core exercise that I like to give to all my clients as it goes across the body. And when we're speaking functionally, any kind of movement that goes diagonally or across the body, there's a lot of great things functionally for you to move and perform. So the first thing you want to do is anchor the cable machine right about, you know, chest height. You don't want it too high or too low because that's a whole other exercise. And what I like to do is by grabbing it and placing my hands together, almost like you're holding your own hand. Now the other option, if you have bigger fingers and your knuckles are hurting, is grab with one hand and then grab over top so the inside hand is on the handle first. So whatever you choose, you want to grab, come out a little bit. You want to have a slight bend in the knees. A lot of people stand up straight and when they try to go, it doesn't feel that great in the low back. So you want to have a slight bend in the knees, engage that core, hands together, and you want to come across the body with any kind of rotation through the hips. Again, that would be a different exercise if we had the back trailing leg twisting, but this one's just a plain cable chop, and what you want to do is come straight across and back. Deep breath in here and exhale as you come across. So depending on what your program has you doing will depend on the reps, and then you do the other side. To troubleshoot this one, if it feels like you're really struggling, just go lower in weight. You don't have to have your ego speaking to you to get the benefit of this exercise. More quality movement than the quantity of weight is always best when it comes to any kind of exercise. So with all that said and done, your cable chop will look perfect.